The Peanut Butter Falcon is the heartwarming story of a man who has Down syndrome who escapes from a nursing home to pursue his dream of becoming a pro wrestler. Along his journey, he runs into an outlaw who becomes his ally and best friend. And joining me right now are the writers and directors of The Peanut Butter Falcon, Michael Schwartz and Tyler Nielsen. Hey, guys.
Hey, Jeff.
Hi, Jeff.
Greetings from Las Vegas.
Yeah, greetings from LA. How are you out there? Is it hot?
We're having another heat wave as usual. It's about 110 here today. Yeah, I'm baking in the sun.
Yeah.
Guys, I have to tell you right away, I just love this movie. I simply adore it, especially during a summer of Fast and Furious and Avengers and Godzilla. And this is something for the soul. And I just absolutely love this film from beginning to end. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. I'm excited to be talking to you now. Like, this is a great start to a conversation.
Yeah, hey, what's going on with you, Jeff? Thank you for the compliments. Wow, I feel good. My cup is filled.
Hey guys, I'm speaking from my heart, so it's the truth. I adore this film. But you guys wrote and directed The Peanut Butter Falcon. What's your secret to working together?
Well, if we told you, it wouldn't be our secret, so we can't tell you. Next question. No, I'm just messing, Jeff. I don't think that joke landed, Jeff. I think
Tyler and I are just best friends.
Yeah.
And we like to tell stories together. So I think, we've known each other almost 14 years now and started out as a friendship and would tell each other stories. And then started telling short stories together, so short films and commercials, and then grew together. And really, I think, make each other better. I think there's a thing where I'll be going down a path and Tyler will say to me, hey, what if we did it this way? And I go, oh, even better than I was thinking. Great, let's go that way.
Yeah, and I think we direct a lot when we're writing, so when we get on set, there's not a lot of questions. We already figured it out. And you know, I also trust Mike creatively, like, a ton. So it's nice for, you know, as a team, just be like, I already trust him. Like, I don't think he's going to make any decisions that won't be good for the film. And I think it's a two-way street.
This movie has a classic feel to it. Mark Twain, we're even on the river. Was that your guys' intention?
Yeah, I think, the first thing I read growing up was a lot of that Mark Twain. And the first things I watched in movies were classic Disney and Stand By Me. So the influences, I think we really wanted it to feel like that. And that's even just what's imprinted on Tyler and I is growing up watching that stuff and reading that stuff. And then we really wanted to make a story. I think it's common with independent films or smaller films these days to be really sad. And we wanted it to be really fun and have a lot of range in it.
Yeah, I'm excited about feeling good again. I don't want to feel sad anymore.
So tell me about the journey in casting Zach. How important was that?
I mean, the film really, Zach made the film happen. We'd known him for 3 years before we even started writing the script.
That's 8 years ago now.
Yeah. And he was at an actors camp for people with and without disabilities that we were kind of hanging out at. And he was ready to take the next step and be in features. And we had a conversation one night at dinner and we said, Zach, that's really hard for anybody to do, but there's not a lot of roles written for people with Down syndrome. And he just said, cool, let's do it together. You guys write and direct, and I will star.
Yep.
So Shia and Zach had this secret handshake in the movie. Tell me about the origins of that. Who came up with that?
We wrote it in the script. We never wrote what they did. Shia and Zach created that on their own. That was their own secret handshake. But I think they made it up. We put them in the back of a pickup truck and went and drove south to Dorian, Georgia, from where we were in Savannah, which is a couple hours, because Shia had a job on a crab boat. And I think they made it up in the back of that truck.
I felt there was a lot of moments in the movie that were improv'd, right on the spot. Like when Shia and Zach are slapping each other gently in the back of the truck. Was that planned?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think there's, Shia cares a lot about everything and truth. And Tyler and I are also, I think, really seeking those truthful, honest moments. And we all came in super prepared. So Tyler and I had been preparing for 4 years before we shot. Shia is just a master of preparation, and I think when you know the story that well, you're able to play jazz on top of it and find moments that feel even more authentic. So we're not word perfect directors. We're not just come in and say the words exactly. It's settle in, find how it feels a little bit better for you, and if you can make it a little bit better, make it a little bit better.
There's a tragic backstory to Shia's brother, played by John Bernthal, but he has no dialogue in the film. He's only shown in flashback with images. Was that intentional?
One of those things also, when we were searching for truth and honesty, we said, Shia, who would you want your brother to be? And he says...
Yeah, he'd done Fury with John.
Yeah, so he said, do you mind if I call Johnny Bernthal? And we're like, are you kidding? He's amazing.
Yeah,
he's the Punisher.
So John Bernthal, actually, we talked to him on the phone. Shia, actually, he was in the back of the truck, and he passed the phone forward, and John was like, hey, I'm in. Let's do it. And it was a bigger role, what we had written, but John, when we were in post, we actually called him, and I was like, there's something really beautiful about kind of pulling it back and leaving the audience wanting a little bit more. And I remember feeling a little bit nervous talking to John about that. And he was like, oh, whatever it is, like, I'm really just to be of service to the story. And if that feels good for an audience, I want the audience to have that. So we were like, we ended up dropping that sound out and really just letting it sit quietly.
One of my favorite moments of the film is finding Jasper, the blind man, who ends up baptizing everybody. Where did you find that actor? He was brilliant.
Wayne DeHart.
Yeah, Wayne DeHart. We had a casting director, Tracy, and we had shot, to get the movie made, we went and shot a proof of concept, basically a 5-minute trailer that showed that Zach could do the acting job and what the world felt like. And we'd found a guy out there, Melvin, at the docks, and he'd done a fantastic job. So when we sent that to Tracy, the casting director, we said, do you have anybody, like a trained actor, that could do this?
Yeah.
And she sent us Wayne, and we were just like, he's perfect.
He's great.
He's great.
One of the funniest moments in the movie is Shia is riding up front in the truck, and there's this giant dog next to him who just keeps panting in his face. It never turns its head. Was that improv, or was that written in the script?
No, that was written. We wrote that.
Yeah, we wrote that, and that's a professional acting dog.
Yeah, that dog got paid.
Yeah, I mean, and he beat out two other dogs. They brought three dogs to set that day,
and
he said,
that's the one.
One of the characters of the film is the locations. I mean, I could not wait for each scene to see what kind of setups you guys had in store. We were in deltas, we were in cornfields. It was just beautiful. Was it exciting to go location scouting for the film as watching it?
Oh yeah, it was actually Mike and I. Like we had a great locations department, but before that, Mike and I got there like 6 weeks early, and went and tried to find every single possible location we could, and we found places we loved. And our producers, you know, even though there were big company moves, like the silo scene, you know, there's scenes, and I don't want to give anything away, but there's a lot of stuff that our producers were like, that's really far to shoot a small scene. For example, a sinking island in the middle of the ocean, but we'll support you guys, and you guys can go take a bunch of boats out to a sinking island.
Yeah, our water, but we had an armada of like 5 or 6 boats with the crew on it, and it was such an adventure. Like, it's an adventure story, and I think Tyler and I are adventure guys, so it was really fun to be going out there and having the tide rising and losing our location and running around.
Sharks swimming in the foreground.
You see the shark?
Yeah, did you see that?
Yes, I did see the shark. That was crazy. I thought that was maybe a special effect, but that actually had sharks around your feet. Well, it just shows how dedicated you guys are, standing with sharks. Guys, thank you so much for speaking to me today. I love this film. Award season is coming up. I will be championing this film for recognition. Thank you again. And when you have a chance, come visit us in Las Vegas. We'd love to have you.
Oh, thank you, Jeff.
All right, thanks so much.
You need a name.
Falcon. Peanut Butter Falcon!
Do yourself a favor and see one of the most heartwarming films of the year, The Peanut Butter Falcon, now in theaters. And for more reviews and interviews, just surf on over to my website at vegasfilmcritic.com. I'm Jeffrey K. Howard in Las Vegas. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you next time.